Here's a pre-World War II Sturmey Archer engine that I've been working on the rebuild of, and I totally stripped it and fitted a new big end, the big end made by Alpha Bearings. I split the crank and fitted the big end that they supplied for the Conrod. They reconditioned the Conrod. I put the crank back together and trued it, and fitted new main bearings, and even made up a spacer to go, see it behind timing pinion there to locate the crank to stop it trying to wander over to that side, because the ball bearing is on this side and the roller bearing is on this side in this engine. So I've got the crank nicely located, no end float, and spinning nice and freely with new main bearings and a new big end. See that roll back there. With the timing gears fitted as well, so that's nice and free. That one there is just an oil pump drive gear actually. So now I can concentrate. I've got the timing sorted out, the valve timing, and I made a nut up for the very coarse thread that was on the end of this crank, but had no nut for it. So I've done all that and made a tab washer up. It's all tightened up now. The cam timing's done, so my next job, I think, is I'm going to fit the cylinder barrel and the piston next. I've got the timing cover here, but I can't fit that yet because I've got a little problem with the oil pump assembly. I've got to do something about this broken missing bit. And the oil pump fits up inside that hole there underneath. This gear on the oil pump engages with this little worm gear on the back of this gear, so the oil pump has to be fitted in there first before this. And with that gear in place, I can't fit the oil pump, so therefore I can't fit the timing cover either. So soon I'm going to have to do something about this, get that fitted, then get this gear in, and then the timing cover can go on. But meanwhile, I'm going to fit the piston and cylinder barrel next, and it'll be another big step in the right direction.